So let's move on to our next topic. So as I said, this was a jam-packed week. And it wasn't just because this news came out of left field. Like, none of us knew that the NES Classic news was coming. But we did know there was a Nintendo Direct happening.
Well, I didn't, but...
Well, again, the Switch is, like, bringing him into the fold, and it's been 3 weeks, so I didn't beat him over the head. I should have let him know. I think I told you the day of, but
yes,
it was happening
you
while you were at work.
Yes.
So I was like, should I tell him that maybe he should watch it? Eventually, he'll just watch it on his own. Like, he'll show up, and he'll be like, dude, did you see that Nintendo Direct? I'll be like, wait a second, you watched it? I thought I was going to have to watch it with you again.
Yeah, right. So,
there was a Nintendo Direct, and what I found interesting about this Nintendo Direct is they came out and said it was going to be for Nintendo Switch and 3DS games, and they said specifically it would focus on ARMS and Splatoon 2. So, when Nintendo has said this in the past, it's usually like 90% of a Nintendo Direct are the two games they mention, and then they just throw in a few extra tidbits. This Direct was pretty big.
Yeah, there
was a lot of announcements in this thing.
Yeah, a lot more.
I think at one point it was like 40 games or something.
Yeah.
Like 40 games were talked about between 3DS and Switch or something like that. That was like a tally we had at Nintendo Prime on the back end. And some surprising announcements, like Payday 2 is coming to Switch.
That game looks awesome.
Yeah, you can get it on Steam. Like, the thing is it's really weird because I follow this guy, this Jim Sterling fellow. I'm sure some of our audience have heard of him. And he reviewed, like, Payday 2, or reviewed. I don't know if he did an official review. Maybe he did. Because he loved the original Payday. And the problem he had with Payday 2 is, like, everything was, like, microtransaction-y. But from what they said, it sounded like a lot of content's just going to be included with Payday 2. So maybe they're trying to make, you know, Switch people, like, realize, hey, we know how to make good games. Sorry to our PC owners that we made spend, like, an extra $7,000 to get everything. But... Dude, like, Payday 2 is a legit, decent indie offering. Oh, robbing banks, man.
I know. It looked like absolute fun.
Yeah. Yeah, the original Payday was great. I only played it sparingly, and I'm going to play the hell out of this one. We'll probably end up doing some live stream multiplayer action of that. But what I kind of want to get into is, first off, let's talk about what are some of our favorite announcements from this. And let's start with Darren, the third party here.
Well, here's the thing. Pokemon Moon was the last 3DS game that I will ever buy. So none of the 3DS announcements, you know, I was really hyped about.
Why is Pokemon Moon it for you?
Because I have a Switch now, and I'm going to buy Switch games. Like, the 3DS is old news. Like,
so, you didn't buy 3DS games when you had a Wii U?
What'd you say?
So you didn't buy 3DS games when you had a Wii U?
Well, I did, but I treated them like a home console and hand console. Whereas with Switch, I didn't think I would do this, because I usually use a home console more. But I use it primarily as a handheld console, which is... I have to wash my mouth out with soap after saying that, because I thought I would never, ever do that, but I do. I use it in handheld mode most of the time. So it's basically my one console that I'm playing now, and I'm playing in handheld mode.
Sure.
So, I mean, the 3DS, it's up on a box on my shelf, and it's like, I don't want to play Hey Pikmin. I want to play Breath of the Wild and Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Like, there's really nothing on the 3DS that excites me as of right now, unless for some reason they were to announce a new Zelda or Pokemon game for the 3DS, which I highly doubt they'll do. As far as the 3DS stuff in the Direct, really wasn't excited about a lot of that, even though I was very interested to watch it. Just from an analyst point of view, because I am interested in how Nintendo is marketing the 3DS after the Switch's launch. So it was very interesting to watch that. Not hyped at all, really, but I'm glad to know that Nintendo is still supporting 3DS owners. But I think what I mean. Oh, the new Zelda amiibo. Okay, I just remembered that. That's probably the best announcement for me personally that they had, because I love Amiibo and I love
some new Amiibo.
The Legend of Zelda. Yeah, the new Link Amiibo.
That was your favorite announcement out of the whole Direct?
Yeah.
I mean, that's cool if it was. That's just very interesting perspective.
Did I miss anything? Because I did not watch the entire thing, but I caught up on the news afterwards. Like, was there any mind-blowing announcements that I missed?
I wouldn't say mind-blowing, per se. But, we learned a lot of things, like, especially for, well, I guess for both systems, that we didn't really know before. Like Monster Hunter Stories is coming to the West, which reviewed very, very well and out in Japan. So
I've never played a Monster Hunter game in my life, and I'm really not interested in.
Yeah, well, there was that, but here's the thing, you're not interested in 3DS games, so that's not going to tickle your fancy right now, anyways. But what really got me was that this was the Direct where they needed to prove Splatoon 2, improve ARMS, and I feel like they did it. Because Splatoon 2 had a popular opinion out there that it was just Splatoon 1.5. It was just the same game with most of the same maps and the same weapons doing the same thing over and over again. And they came out and they announced, no, one, we have an entirely new mode that's completely different than anything you did in the original Splatoon. And that horde mode or whatever it was. Looks absolutely fantastic. And I can't wait.
I see that perspective. The thing is, I'm not going to buy ARMS. Probably not. I mean, it looks fun, but it doesn't look fun enough because, one, my internet sucks, so I can't really play at my online multiplayer. And number two, I have no friends, so I cannot play at local multiplayer.
Why can't you play local?
Because I have no friends, Nate. So
you have family.
Well, this is true.
Familia.
But they're not really into video games. And then Splatoon 2, I was going to buy it whether it was just a straight port of the original because I never got to play the original.
you not be excited about Splatoon 2?
Well, I am
excited. That should be your number one thing.
I am excited about Splatoon 2, but I already knew about it.
That probably have the same... So, we all kind of already knew there was going to be new Zelda Amiibo.
Yeah, but we didn't get to see them. I already saw Splatoon 2, and it's already been played by...
You're going to be editor-in-chief of Zelda Informer, and you're excited about the thing you knew was going to happen.
Yeah, I'm sorry that I specialize in The Legend of Zelda, and my favorite announcement was the Zelda Amiibo. I mean, I'm kind of disappointed, actually. I'm glad that there's new Zelda Amiibo, because I currently have all the Zelda Amiibo, and I'd like to collect more shelf. But I kind of wanted the Fierce Deity to be an amiibo because, spoilers, not really spoilers. I mean, it's everywhere. The Fierce Deity outfit is in
Breath of the Wild amiibo.
Yeah,
I'm actually surprised that they're like, yeah, we're going to do, what is it? It was a Majora's Mask one, a Skyward Sword, and a Twilight Princess.
The links from the game, and it's like, I'd like... The Fierce Deity and Fi and friggin', I don't know, Midna.
Well, it feels like they should just, Breath of the Wild is doing insanely well at sales. I'm surprised they're not just building on the hype for that, because they're going to have future DLC coming. We have, the four Guardian characters. They all could be amiibo easily. You have the King. He could be amiibo.
Oh, yeah.
Calamity Ganon himself could be an amiibo.
Mm-hmm.
But yet they're just going old school and being like, yeah, we're just going to make some more retro amiibo. And while I appreciate it, I mean, they look fine. They look exactly like their official art.
Yeah.
Maybe what's most disappointing about it to me is that they look exactly like their official art.
Yeah.
It's like someone just took the official art and 3D printed it and handed it to you. Said
it's actually definitely possible that's what they did.
Well, can I just say that
that's
Link,
what I'm saying. Like,
right now, before this announcement... Link was the most produced amiibo. I'm not talking like the first Link Smash Bros. Amiibo. I'm talking Link the character had more variations of amiibo than any other Nintendo character.
Of course.
Other than Mario. Mario. More than Mario. Which is kind of mind-blowing.
Is it more than Mario?
It is more than Mario. And now it is way more than Mario.
You're going to have to... I wish we were the Easy Allies podcast where I had the prove it ticket so I could be like, I need you to go look that up right now.
Okay. Well, I saw a statistic the other day. It was, I don't quote me on this, but it was like the Amiibo Alerts Twitter account or whatever, one of those Amiibo accounts that had compiled the data. So as long as they're legit, that statistic should be legit. I could be wrong. I don't think I am, but.
No, it's okay. I think what I'll do when I'm editing this podcast is I'm actually going to go look up what the number are, and I'm gonna. I just did a fake laugh because I'm gonna laugh like you're wrong if you are wrong, or I'm gonna.
And if I'm wrong, I wrong, have to you're do correct. Something on the next podcast.
Yeah, maybe. I have to do something.
Yeah.
I mean, you're already shirtless, so I don't know what else to do.
Nate, why would you say that? It's the perks.
You're not on camera.
Perks
anymore.
Of yeah, not right. being on camera, ladies and gentlemen. That was a fun fact.
But yeah, no, it's one of those things that I think it's so hard for me to believe it. I mean, there is a lot of Links. There is truly a lot of Link Amiibo. But man, I keep thinking of all the Mario Amiibo. Like, there's a ton of Mario Amiibo.
Yeah, but I mean, just looking at my shelf right now, there's Link Archer, Link Rider, Link friggin' Smash Bros, Wolf Link, Link 8-Bit, Link Ocarina of Time, Toon Link, Other Toon Link. And then what is there for Mario? There's like there's like Smash Mario, Mario Mario, Fire Mario, Gold Mario, and Silver Mario.
There's and more. 30th anniversary, two different 30th anniversary Marios, Catsuit Mario. I'm trying to think. There's a ton of Marios.
Like, okay, are they going to GameStop? They have like Majora's Mask, ones. Twilight Princess, and Skyward Sword Link. So,
well, and there's going to be more Mario Odyssey Mario coming out.
Well, yeah, down the line, but I mean right now.
What do you mean right now? Those are down the line, too. They don't come out yet. They're
okay, but
here.
Out of the Amiibo announced, there are more Link Amiibo.
It's okay.
Mario.
It's a totally irrelevant conversation.
Oh, yeah. But it's still so much fun.
Yeah.
I'm actually quite enjoying
the amazing conversations you get to have when you're a Nintendo fan.
Oh, yeah. Nintendo Prime,
sure.
baby.
For sure.
Eric, what was your favorite thing that happened during the Nintendo Direct that you literally watched just before we started here? So it's really fresh in your mind.
Yeah. I would have to say that overall I was just kind of, meh. It really didn't, like,
wow.
You know.
I'm actually not surprised.
Reach out and slap me with anything?
I'm actually not surprised. The beginning was rough because it was a bunch of 3DS games.
Yeah. That I really had.
I didn't think
no
the beginning was rough,
though,
because I like that, like, little headlines thing they had going
yeah,
on.
Yeah, oh, yeah, that's, like, a new thing. I think they're setting that up for all future Nintendo
yeah, like, that was pretty awesome, and, like, you would try to guess the headlines as they go, yeah. And I kind of laughed, because the last headline was, can you figure out what this headline is? And it's like, oh, it's obviously
yeah.
Amiibo, and that kind of made me laugh, because, like, oh, Nintendo.
Well, it's one of those, Nintendo's always done a really good job presentation-wise. So, I don't want to say, oh, my God, it was bad. Like, no, the presentation was great.
Yeah, yeah.
We're talking about the content of
it. Yeah, it was just kind of, yeah.
Just say I'm not surprised that the Pikmin game has a crappy name? Like, really, I'm going to go play Hey Pikmin on my 3DS. That's Hey with an exclamation point, by the way. You have to type that out.
Did you actually see the logo?
Yes, I did. And
the logo's worse. The logo's worse.
It's like,
well,
dealing
no,
with
the
all
thing.
The like Nintendo's weird stylization, like you have to type Amiibo with
I wonder,
all lowercase and it's plural.
I think their logic
Amiibo.
Behind it is.
Like now you have to type out hey exclamation point Pikmin. Or
it's
this,
not the first time they've done it.
It's worse than like new play control exclamation point.
No, this exact title, they've actually done this exact same thing. It's called Hey Pikachu. It's a game. So, like, yes. Nintendo's actually done this before, and the fact that it's borrowing, like, the exact same title with, like, a very similar format to how they're doing it makes me wonder if this game, because we actually didn't see a lot of this game in the footage, makes me wonder if this game actually functions a lot like Hey Pikachu does. That, like, kind of like Kirby's Epic Yarn and Yoshi's Woolly World, where they're, like, basically the same kind of games. Just with two slightly different play styles to fit the characters.
What is this going to be like a new thing?
The theme is
the Hey Link and Hey Mario next.
Now you won't get Hey Link; it'll be Hey Zelda, by the way. But
right,
because ever since Adventure of Link, Link can't be in the title.
Yeah.
But it's one of those things that I think they're just playing around with it, the hey, whatever, and making these smaller, simpler games and just seeing if they can make that like a series like they've done with the Yarn stuff. The weird thing with the Yarn thing is that they're totally different names. Kirby's Epic Yarn and Yoshi's Woolly World. Totally, you wouldn't even know they're related unless you play both the games. So it's interesting that it's Hey Pikmin and Hey Pikachu. But the thing is, setting the title aside, which is absolutely goofy, and maybe that's the point. Maybe they were trying to attract kids. I don't know. I'm sure my children would think it's funny and want to buy it. Or, yeah, can you buy it for me? No. Ask Santa. Santa's broke too, so don't ask him.
don't waste your time. Get Switch games.
I guarantee you that the very first game Nintendo is going to send Nintendo Prime to review is going to be Hey Pikmin. Oh. No one's going to request it. No one's going to request it, so they're just going to be begging for people to ask to review that game. Yes. The thing is, the game looks good.
Yeah.
It doesn't look bad. It looks like a 2D Pikmin game.
I guess. I've never been in
Pikmin. It's not anything that it looks like what I would think a 2D side-scrolling Pikmin game would look like. I don't know. But while everything was in, what were your favorite parts of it?
Payday 2. Payday was 2. Literally.
When Payday 2, that was the most surprising announcement to me was Payday 2.
Oh, for sure.
I'm just like, wait a second, Payday 2? An M-rated shooting cops game about robbing banks.
Yeah,
Nintendo okayed that to be on their system.
Yeah, right.
It's like
the last time that happened was Devil's Third. We all saw how that went over.
Yeah, but we already know how good Payday 2 is.
From what I've heard, it's pretty awesome. I haven't played it.
It's a solid game. As I said, the issue is the microtransactions. That game itself was nice. So if they fix the microtransaction issue for Switch, then awesome. Like I'm there day one. Payday just looks like a fantastic game. So since no one seems to be excited about anything, I guess I'll speak up a little bit. Obviously, I mentioned before that I'm excited for Splatoon 2. I love the original Splatoon a ton. Funnily enough, I have this kid at the elementary school I work at that just tries to talk to me about Splatoon all the time. Like, dude, I was playing Splatoon all weekend. It's so awesome. He's like, when did you last play Splatoon? I'm like, I don't know, 2 years ago. I'm kind of waiting for Splatoon 2, to be honest. I don't even own a Wii U right now, man. But it's just really cool because he's the only kid I know that's played it, and it kind of showed that like maybe Splatoon kind of did what it originally was intended to do, which was cross barriers and make shooting games feel like everyone can play it, kind of like Smash Bros. Did for fighting games. And I think Splatoon did that very well, and I think Splatoon 2 is going to continue that. And what I liked is that if you pay attention to anything, this is definitely a true sequel to Splatoon. It doesn't feel like they cheated out. Like, they just said, oh, we're done making content for Splatoon 1, so everything we make goes into Splatoon 2. It's more like, no, they had a concrete plan for Splatoon 2. They have a whole giant new mode. Right now, we've seen 4 total maps that are new and only one that's a repeat. That's a very high new-to-old ratio. Mario Kart-esque, if you are. Like, is Mario Kart 8 any less of a Mario Kart game than Mario Kart 7 because they're both racing games that look the same?
Yeah, no.
No, like that's the thing. Nintendo does have series where it feels a little iterative because it's the same thing. Mm-hmm. It's just the same thing plus all this new content. And that's what they're doing with Splatoon 2. And even the old items, they've swapped out all of the specials for completely new things. So even the old items feel new. So again, like in Mario Kart, Double Dash, they're adding new mechanics to things you're used to. And even now, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, they're making it so you can hold 2 items now. Like, they're even changing up that, in addition to new characters and the all-new battle mode and everything.
And maps.
And the maps. And the thing is, yes, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is not a fair comparison to Splatoon 2 because it is Mario Kart 8. Most, like, 95% of the content in that game is Mario Kart 8. So it's not a sequel. That's why it's called Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, not Mario Kart 8 9. Or Mario Kart 9.
Yes. Mario Kart 89. Yes.
89. Mario Kart 89. Yes.
I hope I live. I wouldn't put it past him to call it Mario Kart 89 or Mario Kart 82.
I hope I live to see a day when there's Mario Kart 89. You know how old I'd have to be to see that?
Right.
Oh my god.
I'm just waiting for him to come out with like Mario Kart 8.1 point something.
No, those are updates.
Yeah. No, I know, but I'm waiting for him to actually come out and just say fucking... And just
I actually wonder if they're gonna make another Mario Kart after 8. Well, you would think they have to, but then, like, the big step for Mario Kart 8 is now we have our HD Mario Kart. And now they're porting that HD Mario Kart and adding content to it, and now they have the ability to continue to update that game on Switch. Why do they need a 9? They could just keep adding to 8.
New maps.
Like, all the other times that they made a new Mario Kart, they had a reason to. It was a new system, games weren't backwards compatible, there was more graphic capabilities, but there isn't really anything visually more you really want out of Mario Kart at this point. 8 kind of perfected it already. So now you're just kind of stuck with, like, they could have done a Mario Kart 9 because, you know, Wii U games don't play on Switch, but they didn't. They ported Mario Kart 8, so...
Yeah, I gotta say, Mario Kart 8 is, like, really beautiful, and I know the Treehouse did say it was 1080p, 60 frames per second on Switch, so, yeah, I mean, what more do you want out of the visuals, unless you want
to change it? It's basically 1080p, I'm sorry, it was 1080p 59 on Wii U, because there was a frame issue that they never fixed.
I said 1080p 60 on Switch.
On Switch. I know. I was just noting that it was basically that already on.
Oh, okay.
Like, it's not. It's actually not much of an upgrade.
Gotcha.
But again, they're doing more with the Switch version. Like, now you have two items. Didn't have two items on. You know, maybe the Wii U can do two items. So that was an idea they just couldn't do there. The battle mode. Maybe they couldn't make battle mode work on Wii U because of how limited it was. I don't know. But either way, we have everything we want for that. At least. But, you know, you look at the Direct itself, and I came away, I guess, more excited. Maybe it was because out of the three of us, I was the only one covering the Direct, right? Darren wasn't even around, so it was other people doing the stuff at Zelda Informer, which is basically one post about Amiibo. I was handling all the stuff at Nintendo Prime. If I wasn't posting it, the two other writers that I had, Anna and Jessica, did a fantastic job, but I had to copy edit all of their stuff to get it live. So I literally saw every single piece of news there was for this thing because I didn't get to see it live either. I was at my other job. So I was excited. The more and more stuff I kept putting up, the more and more excited I kept getting about things. I'm probably the only one among the three of us that I want Arms Day 1. Period. And not just because I bought a second set of Joy-Cons ahead of time, knowing that I was going to buy ARMS.
Oh, congratulations, Eric. I think we found someone that wants to play ARMS.
Yeah?
No, like, I don't... you just watch it and it's not appealing to you, then I guess it's not appealing to you. To me, it's literally the next evolution in fighting games. Because this is a fighting genre game. This is their next Smash Bros., except, you know, a totally different kind of game. Like, maybe it's more comparable to, like, a Street Fighter or something. Like, this is their entry into, like, really... Like, there's a lot of stuff behind this. A lot of strategy. A lot of hardcore strategy behind all this. And it doesn't require motion controls. That's the one thing I was hoping they were going to show in this Direct was how to play it without motion controls. Again, they didn't do it. They just keep saying you can. And I get it. They're trying to push the motion controls. But honestly, unless the motion controls are literally just that much better than the standard controls... In tournaments and stuff, it's going to be standard controls being played.
Can I just say I'm really sad that it didn't make it to EVO 2017? I'm really sad about that.
Well, it didn't.
It was up for... like, you could donate money for a bunch of different games, and the one with the highest amount won. And it looked like ARMS was going to get the most amount of money, but then at the last minute, like... another game got a bunch more money. And I was kind of sad because I would love to see competitive ARMS. That would be amazing.
It's going to happen. I think the big thing with ARMS is that it needs to get out in the public first so the fighting community can get a grips around it, not just to get good at it, but to see if it fits in with that kind of community. It seems like it would. And I think one thing that helps it stand out from other fighting games is it's got a 2v2 mode. And imagine that in a tournament setting where you have to have a team of two.
That part did look pretty cool.
Like, just the strategies, the counters, you know, the different ways you can deck out your character, and all the different movesets, the elemental stuff. You know, the visuals look great. It looks like it's running in a perfect 60 FPS, which is needed for hardcore fighters. To me, it's trying to do what Splatoon 2... or the original Splatoon, I should say, did for shooters. That was Nintendo's entry into multiplayer shooters, and they did it their way. This is Nintendo's entry into a hardcore fighting scene, doing it their way. Like, Smash was never intended to be a hardcore fighting scene game. It just became that. And even Nintendo has only sparingly supported the idea of it being that way, because the creator of Smash Bros. Only sparingly supports it. He doesn't think it should be a serious fighting game. Sakurai is not in support of it being a serious fighting game, but Nintendo knows people treat it as a serious fighting game. But ARMS is, like, intended to be a serious fighting game, just like Splatoon, and the way Nintendo's pushing Splatoon 2 is now intended to be a kind of serious multiplayer shooting game. Like, they want tournaments of it. They first showed the game off in a fake Evo setting with hardcore tournament players.
Yeah.
So, like, Nintendo wants Splatoon 2 to be in the tournaments and be an eSport, and they want ARMS to be an eSport. And I'm really excited about what they're doing with ARMS, because it is the first time, like, I'm not really big into the fighting game genre, right? Like, I like Smash Bros. Because it's my favorite Nintendo characters battling it out. And that's about it. Like, there isn't really other fighting games I enjoy that much. Like, I wanted to like PlayStation All-Stars, but it wasn't very good. It was Sony's attempt at a Smash Bros. Clone. It just wasn't good. I like those Sony characters. Wasn't good. But, like, Street Fighter 2 and all these other, like, I keep bringing up Street Fighter 2 because there's a new version of it coming to the Switch. There's a lot of fighting games out there. SMT, Street Fighter 4, Tekken. Like, all these fighting games out there, I'm just not into them. When I was a kid, I played them a lot more. I remember playing Primal Rage, playing the hell out of Primal Rage.
Mm-hmm.
Especially at arcades. I loved Primal Rage, dude. Like, a Velociraptor kicking ass. Like, it's just sick. Dinosaurs fighting. I don't know why dinosaur fighting games went away.
It's dinosaurs.
Yeah, I know. But come on. Dinosaurs, that's why. It's like Jurassic Park era.
Right.
Dinosaur fighting game. Like, oh, this is perfect. I need the giant gorilla. Oh, God, I love Primal Rage. They need to bring that back. A new Primal Rage for today's era of gaming. Indie developers. I'm giving you ideas here. But no. It ARMS is a very exciting game to me because it feels like the first fighting game I've watched I actually want to play, because it's doing something different than what I played 20 years ago. Most fighting games, even Smash Bros. To be honest, abides by what I like. When I played Smash Bros. On Wii U, and when I played the inevitable port or brand new Smash Bros. Game they make for Switch, it still felt like just like the game I was playing back in the N64. Yes, I know it's different. I know the pacing is different. I know they added more movesets, more items, more characters, this and that. But, in terms of me playing it, it feels the same. And that's expected, I guess, because it's in the same series. But I feel that way about all games. Street Fighter 4 feels like Street Fighter 3. It feels like Street Fighter 2.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, they visually look different. They added new moves. But in general, how they play is, it just feels very similar and very, very familiar. And that's fine, but it also feels like fighting games haven't advanced beyond that. Even when new fighting games come out, they just feel like all the other fighting games. Whereas this one's the first one that, like, dude, if the motion controls are better than standard controls, and this is the first fighting game where you want to use motion controls because that gives you the best advantage. And not only do you want to use motion controls, how you are fighting is completely different. You're fighting in a physical 3D arena space instead of just two 3D models smashing together on a flat screen.
Yeah.
In a single plane. And doing it in a way that's better than even like Pocket Monsters tried to do it, or Pokken Tournament, I should say, tried to do it. And doing it in highly unique ways with very customizable characters, which usually the characters aren't that customizable in fighting games. You just change some colors up. It's usually mm-hmm. about it. The characters are what they are. You master them.
Yep.
And so this game just looks, it looks intriguing to me. Now, whether it's going to hold up once I have it, I don't know. I do want to kind of try before I buy. Hopefully Nintendo gives me that ability. Review copies. I know. Never got a review copy of Breath of the Wild for Zelda Informer there. Nintendo, what's up with that?
Yeah, what's up with that?
Well, what's up with that? What's up with that? I'm still editor-in-chief there for like another couple weeks, man. Where's my review copy? No, it's okay. And the thing is, they told me...
You have it. It's called your own copy now.
No, they told me, like, oh, we'll give you a Wii U one. Never got my Wii U copy. I probably just gave it away, to be honest, because I don't own a Wii U. But, or maybe we have a poor staff member who doesn't have the game yet. Possible. It's possible. This Direct, I think, was a necessary one in that it didn't have a lot of really exciting announcements besides like things like Payday 2, But what it gave me is, one, for people who don't own a Switch but own a 3DS, it let them know, hey, look, we still have good games coming out for you. Yeah, maybe you don't like the title of Hey Pikmin, but the game looked good. We have Monster Hunter Stories coming. We have, I can't remember, there was a couple other like RPG kind of games they have coming. And the fact that I don't remember the rest of the 3DS games isn't to knock on them. It's because I also don't play my 3DS anymore. Ever since I got Switch, I have not turned on my 3DS. I haven't felt a need to.
Yep.
Probably if I get a review copy of a game, that's about it. Or if I'm going to live stream one. Otherwise, I don't really have a reason to pick up my 3DS. Because the Switch gives me everything I want. Because it's portable, and I get higher quality games in a portable form. And I like that. I didn't know that's what I wanted it for until I had it. Now, I am unlike you and Darren. Eric and Darren, you guys mostly play your thing in portable mode.
I still have yet to dock mine.
I do dock mine all the time.
Yeah.
Because you, like, maybe it's because you still live with your parents. Like, maybe you don't have, like, do you have your plasma in your room?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, how did you not hook that thing up to a plasma and play Breath of the Wild on the big screen while you're in bed?
No, I know. I plan on it.
What's wrong with you?
I know. I plan on it.
As Reggie says, what's wrong with you?
Yeah.
Is your body not ready?
Yeah.
Not ready for that big plasma screen experience? But no, I played it a lot in dock mode. It's great. I played it a lot on dock mode. It's awesome. I played it in tabletop mode a lot. Like when I'm over at the elementary school with the kids, I played it with, like, some 1-2 Switch and stuff with them. Surprisingly, I'm surprised how well it works in tabletop mode. But I guess my general gist of this whole Direct is that it felt necessary in that, one, there's quite a bit of content coming to Switch between now and E3. I'm surprised ARMS is pushed to June, because that officially takes it out of spring. But whatever, ARMS is in June. You have Splatoon 2 in July. ARMS actually hits like right at the end of E3. It's really weird. So again, they're going to talk about it at E3. Of course, because they're going to push it as an eSport and try to get everyone to get all hyped about it before launch. But, you know, we have Minecraft.
Yeah.
Coming out next month. That's kind of like the biggest game coming to Switch next month. I know people are like, oh, Minecraft. Yeah, but still, it's Minecraft. And it's a very popular game, and it's hitting early in the life cycle instead of at the end like it did with Wii U.
Right, and actually, I kind of like the Nintendo flavor that it added, the giant Mario, that's a DLC pack
they added to it on Wii U, and now it's just included, which is great.
That does look pretty freaking cool.
It does look cool. And the thing is, I'm not a big Minecraft player. I'm afraid to play Minecraft. Like, my daughter loves Minecraft. Like, yeah. As soon as she notices I have Minecraft on my Switch, I'll probably never get my Switch back. She is like a Minecraft addict. And she's only 6, so it's only going to get worse from here. I'm afraid to get into Minecraft because I know it's going to be like World of Warcraft for me. It's going to be crack.
Mm-hmm. And I'm it not will consume stuff, you, it's speaking from Legos. Experience.
Yes. So, anyways, it's still good that it's coming. It's not a bad game. Mm-hmm. Great game. What I saw is that Nintendo has a ton of indie and small game support for the Switch, like a ton. And this is despite the fact that we know now that Nintendo has been kind of limiting who could be on the Switch at the beginning, maybe to give games a longer run for indies. But they have that. They have 2 bigger games coming. And then after that, it's kind of a question mark. But I feel like they needed to get all this stuff out of the way for Switch and 3DS now, because E3 is coming up in 2 months from now. Like, almost to a T, 2 months from now. And that's where they're going to have all the big ones. That's where they're going to show off Mario Odyssey, more of that. And that's where they're going to have all their big, big announcements that are going to get you hyped for the rest of the year and get you hyped into 2018. And I feel like if they didn't talk about this stuff, even the stuff that comes out after E3, like, say they didn't talk about Splatoon 2 now and they waited until E3, they waited to talk about ARMS until E3, I think it would take away time from the E3 presentation that they need to be putting into hyping the system for things that are coming down the line. Because right now, after this Direct, we know everything coming to 3DS and Wii U, and not Wii U, sorry, 3DS and Switch for like the next 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
We know. Our next 3 months are taken care of. So E3 will now be what's next. And I think it was very important they got this out now. And also, fun fact, ever since they launched Nintendo Direct, there's been a Nintendo Direct every April. It is the only month they have consistently released a Nintendo Direct in every year.
Huh.
Kind of a cool little fact. But I guess we don't really have much else to say, because none of us were overly excited. I'm really excited for ARMS, obviously.
I think it looks like a fun game. I don't know if I'm going to get it day one.
Well, but I think because I have it, it also helps where, like, you'll get to play with me.
Right. Right. It's one of those things that it looks like something I would possibly pick up, but it might not be day one.
Like, is it going to, like, are you going to get Splatoon day one? Splatoon 2?
More than likely, yeah.
Okay. So, that's the thing. I think it's going to be one of those, if you end up loving Splatoon, I could see you deciding, you know what? This is a new IP. It was great. Let me try ARMS. Then you'll try it on mine and be like,
yeah, no, it does look like a fun game. It's just, it's one of those things that I don't know if I'm going to get day one.
Mm-hmm.